I welcome you back to this online series on aircraft performance. In today's lecture, we'll be discussing about the range and endurance of a jet engine aircraft. Let's begin. Before moving on to the analysis of range and endurance for a jet engine aircraft, let's do a quick revision of how we finish the analysis of propeller aircraft. Right? Propeller aircraft, the idea is it generates power rather than the thrust directly, whereas the thrust is generated by propeller blades. So in order to do the analysis, we introduced a term called as specific fuel consumption, which is nothing but the amount of fuel consumed to generate 1 bhp of power in 1 hour, right? So that is specific fuel consumption for a propeller driven aircraft. Now then we move on to understand the conditions for range and endurance for propeller aircraft, and we introduced a product that is C into P into DT, where C is the specific fuel consumption and P is the power available, which is same as the power required at given velocity, and DT is the increment in time, right? So this product we introduced, and it gave the decrement of fuel with respect to time DT, right? So then we moved on to derive the quantitative formulation for range as well as endurance, and we understood that both the range and endurance curves, the area under this curve represents the respective quantities, right? If I draw a curve whose y-axis is 1 by cp, the area under the curve would have given endurance for propeller aircraft. Similarly, if the y-axis is v infinity by c into p, the area under the curve would have given the range for propeller aircraft. Clear? Then we moved on to define a new parameter called as propeller efficiency, which reduces the power which is available at the shaft and the amount of power which actually gets transmitted to the propeller blades. Right? Then we moved on to derive the Breguet range equation, which tells that for a propeller aircraft, the maximum range is possible if the aircraft flies at CL by CD max. So we understood the Breguet range formula and various parameters it depends on. So very important in that is CL by CD max. Then we understood the endurance for propeller aircraft and on what parameters it depends on. Apart from all other ratios, the endurance also depends on density, whereas range doesn't depend on density, right? So please understand few differences. Whereas for a propeller aircraft, you can get the maximum range when CL by CD is max, whereas you can get maximum endurance when CL power 3 by 2 by CD is maximum. Then of course, in both the cases, you need to carry high amount of fuel, or the weight of the fuel should be high in both the cases, right? So the same principles we will try to apply for jet aircraft as well, right? So in order to get the equations for jet powered aircraft, I need to define a new tool called as thrust specific fuel consumption. Any idea what is thrust specific fuel consumption? It is same as specific fuel consumption, but we are replacing the power with thrust. It is defined as the weight of the fuel consumed to generate unit amount of thrust per unit time, right? In British units, it is nothing but the pounds of fuel consumed to the pound of thrust generated in unit time. So let's call that as equation number 9. So if I draw a graph for thrust required and versus velocity, I get this particular shape where the minimum thrust required results in maximum endurance for a jet aircraft, correct? And remember, for jet aircraft, now this particular curve represents the thrust required curve, of course, and the x-axis is velocity, right? It is nothing but the variation of thrust required with velocity, right? So if I draw a tangent from the origin to the curve, thrust required curve, I get a point which represents the velocity for maximum range, or in other words, that point actually represents CL power 1 by 2 by CD max. And of course, the minimum thrust required condition occurs at CL by CD max. Clear? Getting the point? So we have, for maximum endurance for a jet aircraft occurs at CL by CD max, whereas the maximum range occurs at CL power 1 by 2 by CD max. Clear? Now, if you understand, there exists a clear relationship between the velocity for maximum endurance and velocity for maximum range. You need to observe and understand one thing here. If you fly at a velocity where CL by CD is maximum, the jet aircraft is not going to achieve maximum range, whereas it is going to achieve maximum endurance. But if you fly at a velocity where CL power 1 by 2 by CD is maximum, the jet aircraft is going to achieve maximum range. Understood? So, two important concepts you have to understand. Both maximum range and maximum endurance cannot be achieved at a given velocity, right? These two velocities are different. They are not same. I cannot get maximum endurance and maximum range at the same time. Not possible. If I want to get maximum range, I should fly at CL power 1 by 2 by CD max. If I need maximum endurance, I should change the velocity of my aircraft such that CL by CD is maximum. Next, we will try to understand the units and dimensions of the thrust specific fuel consumption, right? So the unit of thrust specific fuel consumption in MKS is pounds of fuel per pounds of thrust generated multiplied by seconds, that is per unit time. Or in SI unit, you can represent it as the Newton of fuel consumed to the Newtons of thrust generated multiplied by time, right? Now, in order to continue the analysis, I am going to introduce a new product called as the thrust specific fuel consumption CT multiplied by the thrust available and multiplied by the time increment. So this product is going to give me the newtons of fuel getting consumed in a time dt, right? It represents the differential change in weight of the fuel due to consumption of the fuel over a short period of time dt. Now, with the same analysis, I got the fundamental equations for range and endurance for a jet aircraft. As for endurance, I have the integral from W1 to W0 dW by CT into TA, where CT is the thrust specific fuel consumption and TA is the thrust available. Clear? Let's call this as equation number 10. And if I try to represent this in a graph of 1 by CT into TA versus weight of the aircraft, the area under this curve represents the endurance for a jet engine aircraft. Clear? Similarly, for range, I can obtain an expression which is equal to the integral of W1 to W0 multiplied by integral of W1 to W0 of V infinity by CT into TA into dW, right? Let's call this as equation number 11. And if I draw a graph, V infinity by CT into TA versus W, the area under this graph represents the range of a jet-propelled aircraft. Let's move on to derive the Breguet range equation for a jet aircraft. I'm not going to discuss the derivation here. You can refer aircraft performance and design by Anderson for that. The procedure is same as for propeller aircraft, right? You have to replace the specific fuel consumption by thrust specific fuel consumption, right? So finally, I am more interested in understanding the range equation rather than getting at the equation. Getting at the equation, the methodology is same, there is no change, right? So let's try to understand this equation, and I am calling that equation as equation number 12. So you can obtain the maximum range for a jet aircraft when the thrust specific fuel consumption is minimum. Of course, this is one obvious observation you can make for all the four equations, that is range and endurance for jet and propeller aircraft. Minimum fuel consumption or thrust specific fuel consumption results in maximum range, maximum endurance, more range and endurance for jet engine as well as for propeller engine aircraft. Clear? So this one point is common in all the four equations. Then of course I have maximum fuel weight. This is also a common trait in all the four equations. If you carry more fuel, you can cover more range and endurance will be more. Clear? But the important changes comes here. What is that? The ratio of coefficient of lift to coefficient of drag. So for maximum range, for a jet engine aircraft, you should fly at CL power 1 by 2 by CD max. Right? Just now we saw the graph, how we can achieve that. Understood? So CL power 1 by 2 by CD max gives the aircraft maximum range if it is a jet aircraft. And also if the aircraft flies at higher altitude, range will be high, because here in this equation, the density is inversely proportional to range. As the altitude increases, density is going to reduce and range is going to increase. That is the reason why turbofan engines are used for intercontinental travel, and propeller aircrafts are used for local travel, let's say between New Delhi and Mumbai. They may use the propeller aircraft, which gives better efficiency at lower altitudes. Whereas if I want to travel to New York from Delhi, so I would prefer to buy a turbofan engined aircraft rather than propeller aircraft, because the distance is more. So I want to travel at higher altitudes to reduce the fuel consumption. So this question has been asked in many interviews. Why or what is your preference of aircraft for intercontinental travel, right? So many of them can answer this question, but you should know the reason behind the answer, right? So this is the reason. The range is inversely proportional to density. So as the altitude increases, density is going to reduce. As density reduces, range is going to increase. Let's move on to the endurance equation. I got the endurance equation as the same as I got for propeller aircraft. Endurance is given by 1 by CD, that is the thrust specific fuel consumption, multiplied by CL by CD into natural logarithm of W0 by W1. So you observe carefully, apart from all other parameters, that is, if you fly at minimum thrust specific fuel consumption, definitely the endurance is going to increase. Apart from that, the point you should understand here is, if the aircraft flies at CL by CD max, right, then it is going to get maximum endurance for this particular condition. Understood? So for a jet aircraft, you can get maximum endurance if the ratio of coefficient of lift to coefficient of drag is maximum. Understood? This is the important point here. And of course, remaining all other points are valid, and they are common to both, for propeller aircraft as well as for jet aircraft. Like, if you carry maximum weight of the fuel, definitely your endurance and range is going to increase. I have repeated this many times. right? So let's call this as equation number 30. I will end this lecture here. In the next lecture, we'll be discussing about the takeoff and landing performance of aircraft. Right? Thank you very much.